But I would like, as he winds up, just to talk about the resistance within the judiciary.
We'll come to that in a minute. Let me
reform, which
hear
we haven't
from
probably talked about.
What's
mine might be unfortunate to those people who are really supporting Shorey, because I think when the sacking came, I said, because of this institution, I think is the right thing. I think my personal opinion is that Shorey overplayed it. And I kept on asking myself, if she's not sacked and this continues, who is boss to who? Who will ever tame this lady at any given time? She was becoming so bossy to herself. And to be very sincere, I was saying, for the sake of the institution, if this lady is not sacked and she continues, who will ever ask her even a single question if there is corruption? I think this was a battle that either she had to lose or the institution loses. And I think there are times when you sacrifice individuals to save an institution or even to save a country. And I think I wish I was in her and tell myself, please, Shorey, calm down a bit. There is a way you can handle this and get out of it. Because there are so many directors. You know, she's not just being accused as a person, but the office that you hold, the back stops at you. That's why we even say the president. We keep on talking about the president. We keep on talking about the minister. We keep on talking about the PS, because you are directly responsible. You are given that job. So if that office that you hold is not functioning and it is being blamed for certain things, then you must also be ready to take responsibility. But I think, to me, she overplayed it and committed GSE to attack. It's like heading a very low ball. And then you are complaining that I kicked your head.
Yeah. You don't think the JSC overplayed their treatment of her?
I'm putting the two together, and I think my judgment is that Shorey did overplay it a bit. That's my view.
Okay. Excellent. And so... Actually,
we treated her with utmost respect and decorum. We did not say one thing about her during the process. We kept quiet. We gagged ourselves. We adhered to our internal process. Of course, during all that time, she was pushing us one day after another. All these emails that have been leaked, like the ones on the Star, who else will have leaked, surely? But I think there's a moral in this story.
Okay, but she's not here to defend herself.
But there's a moral in this story. One is that Kenyans must know that these are public offices. These are not entitlements. So if you are found wanting, you go with your bag. But don't cling to this place like you are entitled to an office, because tomorrow, another Kenyan will replace you. Secondly, I think the moral question is that there is a certain dignified way even to express your displeasure on how you are treated. And I think on that point, Shorey didn't score very well.
Okay, David, you had a question about resistance to the reform.
Yes, I think there is still vibes about resistance to reform within the judiciary. On the bench, and within the structures, is that now dissolved?
I think the judiciary is working very well now. Whether it is, the judges or even the support staff, they are all focused, same direction.
Yeah.
Of course, initially, the initial first 6 months or 1 year, there was that resistance. But
I'll ask, related to that, there have been attacks on the judiciary that, some of the judgments of some, political attacks have been made on the judiciary, those.
Yes.
And then there have been queries about some judges, without getting into specs. Are you satisfied, having vetted and recruited all these judges, that you actually, 2 years down the line, you're still satisfied they're the best, or there are some people you have regrets about, without naming names?
No. It's just like any other job. The issue you are alluding to is still there. Whether there's corruption, whether there's inefficiency, whether there's those are there. But it's not as bad as it used to be. When we are recruiting the new judges, they are very excellent judges we have recruited. But you really can't vouch for people once they're in office. There's temptation, there's all these things. But the judiciary has done remarkably well. Those issues are there, but now there are processes. If there is an issue of incompetence or corruption and it's brought to the attention of the Chief Justice, and the JSC, there's a process to follow. there's a disciplinary process, and there's even a process to remove that person.
Okay. Explain, this is a personal question though. Ahmed Nasir, there's a conflict of interest in your job in that you practice as a lawyer, and yet you also oversee the judges who give rulings on your clients. Prior to the presidential petition, you wrote a column in the Nation Daily on rot within the IEBC, yet you were their lawyer in the petition, and that came from Wenda in Chuka.
You know, there's first, there's no conflict of interest there. Mm-hmm. I mean, the Chief Justice, who is the chairman of the Judicial Service Commission, is the president of the Supreme Court. Is there a conflict of interest between the job he does and JSC? Smoking Wanjala is a representative. Is there a conflict? Why
okay,
is this
you're
conflict?
Actually, no, you're not answering the question.
Yes, but I'm coming. You know, I'm coming.
Okay.
Because if Ahmed, as a member of the lawyers, cannot represent, why is a judge who is sitting, isn't he immune also from the process?
No, you're not answering the question. Yes. Because I think the question is that as a lawyer, you represent clients who appear before judges whom you have oversight of as a commissioner on the JSC.
But this oversight is, you see, the conflict arises that one, if I'm a complainant, for example, I appear in a case before a judge. Yes.
Okay.
Let me explain. Let me explain.
I will explain. Yeah, I will have
explain,
a problem.
If, for example, Judge X, I have done a case, then my client complains, then I sit in the JSC. That's a complaint. But for example, what is the problem of me appearing before a judge in Nakuru who has no problem on any matter? I go, I argue my case. And by the way, I mean, I have lost more cases than I have won as a JSC member. And I move on because the judge, I mean, these are professionals. I mean, a judge will listen to a case depending on the facts and the law and say that Ahmed is either right or wrong. And then I move on.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, I just think that that is an idle question, because then the problem is with the law, because the law society has been represented on the Judicial Service Commission. So whichever way, you'll get a lawyer who must appear, unless you're looking for a retired lawyer.
Yes. And a retired lawyer will not serve that interest, because it is the interest
of the current
actually
practicing
the fraternity. Position of a practicing lawyer in the JSC is very helpful, because when I go to court, there are certain issues we see in terms of difficulties, in terms of processes, in terms of
now
procedures.
And with that, Ahmed, how do you work with the Law Society of Kenya? Because the Law Society of Kenya is like the bank where you can get the best judges. Yeah, I can tell you, and this is a fact, that if there are people who have messed up Kenyans, are lawyers to some extent. I'm not saying journalists are better. But we know that there are lawyers in this country who have really messed up. And LSK appreciates by asking Kenyans to file complaints and all that. But how do you work with LSK so that this bank that you rely on, you can get the best judges, is clean?
No, I think that one will not worry us, because many lawyers actually don't want to become judges. And that's one of the difficulties we have in JSC. Because the people who can make the best judges are people who have been in practice for so long, who knows how the system works, what are the weaknesses. And also when you're a lawyer, for example, of 20 years, you have really honed your skills to know what the issues are. But the biggest problem we have is that lawyers are reluctant to become judges because of the remuneration, because of, I mean, many people don't want to change their lifestyle, you know, being a judge is a little bit more restrictive.
Throughout this interview discussion, you've not said anything critical of the Chief Justice. Is this, are you exercising collective responsibility or are you friends? Is there nothing you see wrong in this whole saga and the Chief Justice's role as the presiding officer in charge of the judiciary?
No, I mean, the Chief Justice, like anybody else, has weaknesses and strengths.
We'd like to hear those.
And but I think there are more of his strengths we see than his weaknesses. and the only weakness, I think, in the Sholei saga was, I think the JSC could have been more decisive than allowing this thing to roll on for so long. I mean, there's a time she was so abusive, you know. If you look at,
but it does seem though, going by what happened, it does seem though that going by their appearances here on Cheche, that they enjoyed a good working relationship, and at some point, it felt like because she was, her profile was growing too much, that he had to be convinced that she was a threat to his own profile. And so a lot of the troubles, which you say that she has authored, and you will wait for the outcome of the investigations, but it does seem as if there has been some sort of poisoning of the air between the Chief Justice and the former Chief Registrar?
You know, I don't know that personally, you know, working mm. relationship, but you see, I don't think there's anybody who can have a higher profile than the Chief Justice
right.
in the judiciary. And you see, you can have very good personal rapport. And we had even an excellent rapport with her, I can tell mm. you, as yeah. JSC and even as Finance Committee. But there's a call to duty, you know, that overrides that personal relationship. I mean, the Chief Justice may have an excellent personal relationship, but when the issues that crop up came up, I mean, there's no way he could have overlooked it. He must answer the call to
there
duty.
There was the issue of the War Council yes. At the CJ's office. I think you scattered it when David tried to ask. And names were mentioned. And these are names that we know. And of course, I'm sure you also heard about those names. We are also privy to some of this information that, of course, when the CJ, when these things were happening, did not just sit there and wait until Ahmed would come to Cheche or a certain newspaper or radio station would do this and that. The CJ must have done something. Or the JSC itself said, how do we approach this one? Was there a war council really? Or are there people working in the CJ's office who can make his work more complicated and mess up relations with others?
No, you see, I mean, the office of the CJ is a big office. Originally, when he came to office, the office of the CJ had a Tigal and a secretary. That's what it had. The office of the Chief Justice had a Tigal and one secretary. But when William Mutunga became Chief Justice, we transformed that court. I mean, it has legal counsel, it has researchers, it has PR guys, it has, so, I mean, it's a real office of Chief Justice, about maybe 15. And even we want to make it stronger because an office of the Chief Justice must be really, you know, I mean, it must have experts in IT, all these things. So there are all these kind of things. But the work, and also, let's be fair, the Chief Justice is entitled to have people he can discuss issues in confidence.
So was there a war council and were those emails genuine?
Those emails, when we asked the lawyer for Shule whether they were genuine or not, he said, I cannot vouch for them. But he said, probably they are not genuine. That's what he said.
No.
It's on record.
To your knowledge,
yes.
Since you talked to the Chief Justice and you're in the JSC,
yes.
Did he have a war council? Of course, you have just said he's entitled.
No. I don't know whether it can be a war council. The CJ has a lot of people.
Can you tell us what's the role of Duncan?
Duncan is the Chief of Staff.
Yeah.
He's the Chief of Staff.
Does his work not conflict with the other staff members, like even the Chief Registrar?
No. He's the Chief of Staff. You know, he looks after the issues of the Chief Justice.
Okay.
It doesn't. It cannot conflict with any other person.
When you say that Mrs. Chalet's lawyer says that he cannot vouch for it, he can't vouch for it. He's a lawyer for Mrs. Chalet. I mean, that's not his email account. But as David says, you speak to the Chief Justice. I'm sure you have asked the Chief Justice about these emails.
Yes, what did
he say?
The Chief Justice says that those emails were substantively doctored.
Substantively?
Yes.
Okay, so...
In other words, for example, there's an email that said Ahmed Nasir is... The biggest problem.
Okay, fine. Substantively doctored.
Yes.
But were there emails which exist purporting to show the existence of a war council which felt threatened by the profile of Mrs. Chalet?
You know, first, there's a misconception. The profile of Chalet cannot threaten anybody in the judiciary. As I told
you, they were doctored to that effect.
No, as I told you, in the structure of the judiciary, Chalet cannot overshadow the Chief Justice,
or even the other senior. So when he says they were doctored to that effect.
No, they were doctored in terms of what he's saying about other institutions and individuals.
Okay.
Yes. To create an impression that the CJ is fighting so many people, including the Vice President, the President, members of the Judicial Service Commission, judges, I mean, everybody. That is why it becomes very obvious that these are documents that were deliberately doctored to create a bad impression of the Chief Justice.
It says something about the privacy and the security of your ICT, but also just your premises.
Oh, I think the people who have done this are big thugs, you know, maybe. You know, guys who have really decided to do a lot of damage.
I mean,
it's like someone hacking into State House and nobody's complaining about
it. Well, somebody hacked into the ICC's accounts and was able to get the names of witnesses. So that's not new in Kenya, is it? But we are winding up. Any final thoughts, David?
I think we are doing well. the judiciary may not be where we expect it to be, but I think as a country that is coming from those dark days, and I like what you have mentioned, that when we had a chief justice before Mutunga, who had nothing in the office, just sit there, probably a Tigar and somebody. But I think we need to build these institutions. And we depend on you, Ahmed Nasser, and others who are in those positions to help these institutions grow. But we should also lose sight of these complaints, or like what Sholei has done. Of course, she's a Kenyan. Much as we may not agree with her, but let us not dismiss her. Just dismiss her for the sake of it.
Okay. Any final thoughts?
I think Kenyans have played a very important role. The judiciary as an institution belongs to the Kenyan people. Mm-hmm. They should question it, they should interrogate it, they should bring ideas on how it can be better in serving them. When there are issues like this, they must engage it, but I think they should not just write it off, because this judiciary is for the Kenyan people, and when there are issues like this, it should always be handled in such a manner that the institution becomes a pet institution.
Some of our viewers have been suggesting, as AG and Marsabit, that the JSC should be disbanded and investigated. Kenyans are fed up. Beyond the judiciary, the JSC itself, you and your fellow commissioners.
But what have we done to be disbanded?
You are sleeping on the job. All these things happened under your watch. Isn't that where the buck stops? The JSC, you should say, we resign. So much Kenyan money, taxpayers' money was lost.
Take it from me, we are the best performing constitutional commission in this country.
With this scandal, you can still post
not
that
but
result.
It's not a scandal, it is someone, it's an employee who misbehaved and which we have disciplined.
Okay.
You should give us credit for addressing the issue.
Okay, really, because if we take the words of our national anthem, justice be our shield and defender, there are those who feel that you also, within the JSC, need to... be investigated just to restore the integrity.
But that's what Parliament is doing, eh?
Right.
That's what Parliament, someone has petitioned, someone from Meru has done. Mm-hmm. Parliament will investigate. If they have found, for example, that we are not fit for that office, it's a decision Parliament will make and we will live with it.
Okay, yes. Excellent. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much.
That's where Cheche ends this week. Our thanks again to Commissioner Ahmed Nasser Abdullahi of the Judicial Service Commission. As well as he's also the editor of the Nairobi Law Monthly. Our thanks also to panelists David Makali and Waweru Mburu. My name is Udwa Kamimo. I'll thank you for watching, listening, and engaging. And we'll see you next week. Thank you.